As far as compact SUVs go, this Peugeot 2008 is one of the most practical options on the market today. And at around $30,000, it has quickly become one of Car Advisor's favorite cars. Now, for me personally, this has been my family car for the last 4 months when I've done around 7,000 kilometers. And I gotta tell you, it's proven itself to be a little bit of a gem. From the outside, it looks typically French, but without being offensive or overdone. The daytime running lights and the European design cues certainly help its cause, but for me, it's the interior that is most impressive. You see, there's plenty of room in the front and rear seats, and while this is based on the tiny Peugeot 208 city car, it's actually grown in size to accommodate two adults up front and two kids in the back. Now, up here, you've got this beautiful 7-inch high-resolution touchscreen, which not only takes care of your Bluetooth, telephone, and audio connectivity, but also provides a very competent and easy-to-use satellite navigation system. And then you've got this somewhat tiny steering wheel, which looks like it's something out of a video game, but you know what? It makes perfect sense because you get all this extra legroom. There's plenty of clever storage space inside the cabin, but the larger items will need to go in this 410-litre boot. Now, you've got a pram here and a large suitcase, which can easily fit as they are. However, if that is not going to cut it for you, you can actually put the rear seats down and get heaps of more room. Our test car is fitted with a 1.6-litre four-cylinder petrol engine, which pumps out 88 kilowatts of power and 160 newton-meters of torque. Now, these figures are certainly not going to be impressive in the performance sake, and in the 2008's case, that is further hindered by the fact that it's using an aging 4-speed automatic transmission. Behind the wheel, it drives like a regular city car, but with the advantage of sitting a little bit higher up. Now, the four-cylinder engine does tend to struggle if you're going up hills. However, if you're just gonna commute around the city with the odd or infrequent long-distance drive, you're just not gonna be too worried about it. My biggest criticism remains the 4-speed automatic transmission, which is simply too old to be in this car. What that means is you're gonna spend a lot of time going from second to third and then back to second, and that can get quite annoying. We recently put the 2008 against its classic competitors, and while it was a close call with the Holden tracks, we found the Peugeot to be the best in class, and that, for me, is the reason why I've had this car for the last 4 months. Having now done thousands of kilometers in this 2008, including a return trip from Sydney to Brisbane, I've got to be honest, I am so impressed by this little French SUV's ability to accommodate our family of three. So, if you've got a small family, or if you're just looking for a city-focused small SUV that has got European styling and efficiency, as well as excellent value for money, it is quite hard to go past this little pug.